everyone, good afternoon if you are joining us from this part of the world, and good morning, good night, because that's the joy of technology. We connect with people irrespective of what time of the day it is. Welcome to a very special live session. We're coming to you live from the Crosswords page and the Penguin page, and there is no point building suspense because I'm sure you can see a split screen as well if you're watching us either on your laptops or your phone screens. And this is the reason that has got us together. So the two gentlemen here and myself, we're going to be talking about this brand new book, Only the Good Die Young. I have author Akash Verma here. Congratulations on the book.
Hello. And
hello. Okay, we will not stop at a hello. We'll have a full-fledged conversation, but that will be after I welcome my other guest, Rahul Khanna. Hello, how are you doing?
Hi, Stuti. I'm doing good.
You know, this is a thriller, and yeah. I'm sure where Rahul Khanna is at the moment is also equally a mystery. You will not let us in on. So I'll leave that to all of you to figure out. But Pelita, I think we could, if we start with holding up a copy of the book, that would be nice.
Yeah.
Yes, so Only the Good Die Young. Now, I know they say don't judge a book by its cover, by its name, but I would have picked it up either way, just because of the name, Only the Good Die Young, and I am no saint. So Akash Verma is here. I read it. He was very sweet to send the copy over to me. And I read the whole thing and then realized that this is actually a sequel. And it is such a strong, taut thriller and a standalone book. Then at one level, I was like, wow, it didn't feel like it was incomplete, but yet I want to go back and read the predecessor. So congratulations on that, Akash.
Thank you. Thank you, Stuti and Rahul, for joining us. Thank you so much for coming for this launch. Well, actually, that was the brief from the publisher. You know, when I finished writing the first part of it, which is here, which is You Never Know, which you're going to read later, which is what you've promised me, so the idea was to develop a story, a standalone story, taking the lives of Dhruv, Anuradha, Sid and Shalini, the four characters in this book later, and make it standalone for the reader, so that there is no baggage of the old story being carried on, so one can read as a standalone thing. But yes, it serves as a perfect duology in the end. So one has read the book, one leaves the feeling of being overwhelmed at the end of it, and which is I always want to do with my books, is leave the readers overwhelmed. So I hope I am successful in doing that.
You definitely are, and I want to tell everyone, if you haven't picked up a copy of this book, you must. It's available at Crossword, so that should be easy. I want to acknowledge all those who are joining us for this live session, so I can already see your messages. And I must tell you, if there's anything that you want to ask, any comment that you want to make, all you have to do is type those in, and I promise to ask those on your behalf. So there's Neil saying, great to see you, Rahul. And we have Madhurima, there is Sana. Okay, Rahul, coming to you, a man who reads, lovely. You like reading?
I love reading, yeah. But I have to say, of late, I'm not able to do it as much. I think just because we're so overwhelmed with our devices,
yeah,
it's become very difficult to get back to the book. But every time I get back to a book, I'm always happy I did.
I think you make such an interesting point there.
Yeah.
There was a time, I mean, all of us lead busy lives. So you get what, that 1 hour or 2 hours before you go to sleep, to do your stuff, to probably read a book. That's what we would do. And now suddenly there's Netflix and there's just so much distraction. You have online content, you're scrolling on the phone, you're busy. There's Instagram, all of that. So Akash, as writers, it's become tough. You're competing not with fellow writers, but you're competing with all these different agents.
Oh, very tough. Very, very tough. I agree with the point that Rahul made and then you made. Actually, so overall readership, I guess, is growing up year by year. I don't have the numbers. But actually, OTT and mobile content have taken so much part. They've gone so much into our lives that to take someone out of that context and make him read your book is becoming a bit tough. And which is where I think, but for an author, it's a problem to have and a great solution to give. You need to make your book so endearing. Okay, and I look for these reviews where readers say that I finished this book in just one sitting. I love you. I want to tell them at that point in time. So yes, it's more challenging and as well as endearing. It's a task that one needs to do. Problem area that one needs to solve.
Rahul, you worked extensively in the visual medium, Hannah. So I'm just a guess, probably, that the books that you particularly probably are fond of are ones that are more visual to read. Do you, does a screenplay start forming in your head? Does that happen?
I'm generally a visual person, so I need anything I interact with to have a visual element. If it doesn't have a visual element, I can't relate to it, or I convert it into visuals, which is why I like reading physical books. I don't like devices, books that are on devices, because I also remember the place I'm in by the inches of pages or where physically it is in a book. So I like that tactileness of a book. That said, I also like, I'm very curious. So if there's a word I don't know, I need to look it up. If there's something that I don't know about, I need to take a minute, get onto a device, look it up, research it, and then sometimes you go down a rabbit hole and don't come back. But to answer your question, do I start seeing it as a movie or a TV show? Always. Yeah. Absolutely always. Because I think at the heart of any good content, television or film, is the story. And that's why writing will never go away. Because there have to be good stories for good content to be made. And that comes from a writer. So whether the writer starts off the story as a book or starts it off straight away as a screenplay, it has to be, it has to come from the writer. So the writer is really the seed of any good content.
Perfect. Perfectly put, actually.
In my mind, yeah.
No, that's absolutely true. I review films, and I believe every time you're speaking about a good film, you can't reveal the plot. The fun goes. And similarly, that's the problem with thrillers. So I'm going to be a little careful and literally walk, tread very carefully, because I don't want to reveal what's in here. That is what I want all of you to read. I know Rahul is supposed to read this. I have finished it, and so I can tell you, you're going to definitely enjoy it. But Akash, coming to you, how tough was it? You wrote the first book, the prequel to this. Of course, you would, you went through the whole grind of writing a book and all of that. But is the sequel tougher? Because generally, even with movies, with shows, we see the expectations or what is it new that they can give us? That's the first thing that viewers want to know. And similar expectations with readers that there's a sequel. Will there be more? Did you feel more under pressure?
Yeah, look, this story of this duology, Stuti. So it's a very complex relationship that we're dealing with. So it's a... In the sense, there are three people involved. So Dhruv, his wife Shalini, and the Radha. Okay. So the relationship is so complex that to bring out the nuances of it again into a sequel and to carry the same chemistry, you don't lose the personality of those three individuals in that sense, and yet keep the thriller aspect of the book intact, So the story going, you introduce so many characters in this book, like Aman Bhalla and Ash and all of those. So
the Bengali doctor, he was very funny.
Yeah, the Bengali doctor, someone else told me, Bankim Da, is very funny. And so there's a very interesting, now that you've named it, I'll tell you how it was more difficult. So when I had written You Never Know, and I had taken, and I had written only The Good Die Young, I had taken it to my publisher and the editor there, Vaishali. And you'd be surprised that I had put in a supernatural angle in the sequel. Okay. And I thought I had done a great job, which all writers tend to think because they are in their own little worlds. And I went to her and she read the book, and she came back a couple of weeks later and she said, it doesn't work. Okay. I was taken aback. I said, why? It's a great looking story. She said, your first book is so believable and relatable and real, about real people. This suddenly makes it a bit unbelievable. So I went back, I wrote for another 5-6 months, and Bankim Da incidentally came then. Bankim Da was not there in the earlier story. So then it kind of came up, then 1 year went because of COVID and all of that. So what this story has been with me for now, so this is the fourth year. My last book came in 2018, so it's 1 year is lost due to COVID, but essentially, yeah. It's very complex. I think I'm not going to attempt any sequel now for a long, long time. At least I think of it.
No, but you can be rest assured now. But I find that very interesting, you know, the fact that you were told straight to your face after you went in thinking, I've nailed it, this doesn't work. Handling rejection, especially when you've reached a level, you're a popular author already, and then for somebody to tell you, no, you know, we don't like your idea, that must be tough.
Look, it's like that. See, one, authors in my mind are any creative field, someone who's doing it. Writing or taking a book out or taking a film out in that sense is a very collaborative process. So a lot of people are, you know, everything is dependent. So there, everything is at stake from their point of view as well. So you have to keep that in mind. And I'm so glad that I did it, because now when I read the final product and I compare it, I don't compare it, but I sometimes go back to my earlier notes, I think this is so much more better. And it was right that, and I was a published author, you know, and so many people are trying to write their books, trying to get their books through a publisher. That's the first big thing. But that's what I want to tell them, that rejection comes at all levels and one shouldn't be afraid of them. And in fact, use that time very constructively in rebuilding your repertoire, rebuilding whatever you have written, and make sure that you kind of hone it till that time and don't just sit back and say, oh my God, my world has crashed, that kind of thing.
You know, I have to look at the comments that are coming in. There's so many of you who are joining in. Thank you so much. If there's anything that you want to ask, a comment that you want to write, just type that in and I'll take it on your behalf. But just to prove that you can't make everyone happy, we have Tulika here saying, I think marrying a supernatural element with a believable story isn't such a bad idea. So, you know, you will find your audience. You know, there is Tina saying, lovely to hear. Akash, Sana says, the only reason I'm up early is you know, is for Rahul Khanna. Rahul, I'm sure, even, you know, given the work that you do, you're out there, you of course receive a lot of love from people, but like just happened, there will be all kinds of comments, right? Everyone has an opinion about what you should do, about your work, about what direction you take. How do you filter all that and kind of, you know, get to the constructive feedback bit? Is that a work in progress for you? Have you mastered it now? Or you don't listen to people at all?
It depends who the person is. If it's someone whose opinion I respect, or it's someone who I know I have something to gain from creatively, then yes, I take it seriously. But if I consider the source. That's my, if the source is not, if I don't feel would be constructive to me, then I do not consider it, no. But if it's someone I admire and I feel has something to add to my work, then yes, of course, I take it very seriously.
You're such a style icon, Rahul. That's also one of the reasons. Don't be surprised. Of course, many would have.
I love the term. I need to print out business cards or something to hand it out.
No, the fact that you are an icon actually ensures that you don't have to hand out your business cards. Everyone knows you. Fantastic. And, you know, everyone actually believes that. But and Akash, you're an entrepreneur. You also deal with fashion. That's how you both got talking. I'm surprised, like with our day jobs, we find it tough to take out time to read. You have a day job and you're writing books.
Yeah.
How is that happening?
Look, we take out time for everything we love. You truly have to realize this. And one is, and you really don't feel when you're something that you love and you're taking out time for it, you don't feel that you're really taking out time. So being an entrepreneur is a very hard grind. It's a startup and there's a lot of work to be done. But having said that, one needs to persevere a lot, which kind of adds on to your writing as well. Another good thing is you can juggle your time, you know. So I can afford to sometimes, when there are no meetings or no work, I can afford to take an early evening off and start writing. I can write early in the day. So those kind of liberties also come with, but it's fun. Ultimately, I think we can do a lot, many things, if we really love them. So we can take out time for that. So it's not, so I look at it like that.
Not bad. Rahul, you said you love reading, and generally, I know people who love reading are somewhere budding authors as well. They'll be like, ek din meri bhi kahani main likhunga. Can we expect a book from you?
You know, I would love to write a book, and there have been several people who've reached out and asked me if I would write something, and I enjoy writing. My issue is, and that's why I admire people like Akash so much, is that it's really difficult to sit down and put words onto paper, onto your screen, and craft something. It takes me hours. If someone asks me to write an article for a magazine or something, it takes me days, because I'll first put something down and then edit it and then re-edit it and then change it and then get feedback from whoever's asked me to do it and then change it all again, and it's a nightmare. So I can't imagine writing a book. So it's really commendable that people like Akash actually have that discipline. And also, it's kind of, I guess it's like a muscle. You just have to exercise it a lot, and the more you do it, the easier it becomes. Or maybe not, I don't know.
No, but one day, I'm sure. One day.
Well, hopefully. Also, I think it also, a lot of it is having inspiration strike you. So having the seed of a story germinate in your imagination and form in your head, and then you can put it down into a story. But so far, I don't have that idea in my head. So if, once inspiration strikes, maybe.
Then maybe, you never know. Okay. Many people joining us. Yes.
So I have to tell you this, that once this event was kind of announced, okay, and a lot of my friends who happen to be book agents who are in this world, who reached out to me and they said that great, Rahul is coming for your event, but can't he write a book also? I said, that's exactly
this, there are many takers, Rahul. I think you just have to wait for that moment, for that apple to drop. Achha.
Exactly.
Vaishali Mathur, she's your editor. She's joining us, and she has a question for Rahul. Please ask Rahul what genre he reads most.
Page turners. My attention span is so, it's like a fruit fly. You know, I'm all over the place. So I need the book to really grip me. So it mostly ends up being thrillers, murder mysteries. I like authors like David Sedaris, who's a humorist, but he's still very engaging, and it's short stories. So you can finish one and not have to commit to the next one for a while. Le Carre, spy thrillers, that sort of thing, I love.
Super. This one is unputdownable, so makes sense you read this one next.
I know, that's why I was so excited to hear it was a thriller.
Akash, I know we promised to be very careful about not revealing, the meaty plot, but these are characters that you have birthed, and which one? I mean, I know it's a tough question, but which one is your favorite? I'm sure. I don't know if parents have favorite kids, but authors, do they have their favorite character? Are they a little biased towards a certain one?
They have to be.
In the first book, which is You Never Know, and it changed. I think it was Sid.
Okay.
But in the second book, it was Anuradha. I love that.
Yeah.
And the way the book ended, I like kind of, more and more. character to write.
Movies, you can see that with directors. Yeah. That they have certain favorite characters, they'll always present them in a slightly more, in a better way.
Yeah.
Their scenes will be better fleshed out. So you can it's natural in a creative sense to have things that excite you more, elements that excite you more within your art.
Yeah, Akash, continue.
I was just saying I share the inspiration of this story. Actually comes, and you'll be very surprised to hear it, comes from a very old film of Gulzar Sahab. And this film is called Ijazat. Anuradha Patel and Rekha. And it's a very beautiful story for two people. And I thought, out of all the content that has been churned on this relationship in particular, over the last few years has been very clear, and it only goes in one direction. I think it was one of the breakthrough movies of its time, which kind of portrayed all these three characters very beautifully in the end.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. While and with a lot of dignity, with a lot of dignity and grace. Yeah.
So that story, that film always stayed with me, you know, and somewhere, so I had to get that story in a very different environment setting out to actually, that's the inspiration from which this dark or edgy or, you know, or revengeful thriller was being written.
No, what you say is so true, because generally, and Rahul, I'd want you also to weigh in on this. We're seeing now, thanks to OTT, thanks to these various other content platforms, that today they finally are accepting the fact that the audience is mature and, you know, they have a certain IQ level and they aren't really insulting that. And you have these different themes where a lot of how we are in real lives is those are the stories that we're seeing on the big screen. They're more relatable. These are characters with shades of gray. There are women who have their flaws, because we're so used to either a fallen woman or a Devi straight away, nothing in between. Similarly with marriages, with relationships, extramarital, always conned upon. And I thought somewhere, I mean, Ijazat was, of course, one of those good films that dealt with this subject so sensitively. I could sense that even in this book, because you've given their relationship a lot of dignity. But generally, you know, there's this whole, the society will scorn, and there's always this vampish tonality that the character will have. Rahul, you see that changing? Do you see this? And does that give you hope that finally, probably, we'll see more of real content around, not just in books, but also on the big screen or small screen?
I'm actually the wrong person to ask that question, because I don't like to see reality in my entertainment.
Okay.
I like something completely outside my reality. I live my reality. I get enough of it in real life. I don't need to see it when I
watch. I know what you're saying, but you know, especially with these themes, like, you know, we've seen marriages a particular way, and then they keep peddling these stereotypes.
I think what you mean is authenticity. So yes, it's great to have more authenticity. That's great to see. But I like to be entertained. So I like there to be authenticity, but for it to be slightly heightened reality. I don't want it to be reality. That's why I like Lakare. You know, I am not a spy. I would love to be a spy. I would love to be an art thief or a jewel thief or... So that's what I want to read. I want to be slightly outside my world. I want to be entranced and fascinated and delighted. I don't want to read about people's everyday life. I know some people love that. It's not for me, no. But authenticity, yes, love it.
Akash?
Yeah, my take is also I am essentially a commercial thriller writer. Okay.
Yeah.
So that's my identity. Okay. So
entertainment happens.
Absolutely. So at the end of it, yes, there'll be glimpses of reality. So the relationships would be carefully handled. But overall, the book needs to be entertaining. Like you meant, you said in the beginning, it needs to be a page turner. So every page that you turn, otherwise the guy will leave the book. He'll move on to something else. So the book needs to be page turner. It needs to be unputdownable. It needs to have things that he can imagine, but he can't see it in his daily life. But he think, but seems realistic, like the way it happens in this book when Sid comes back. So, but entertainment is at the core. I agree.
Perfect. I'm going to now take some questions. We have lots of these coming in. Tulika wants to ask a question to Akash. Do you take time to get into the groove when you're writing, to get back to your book after a day of work? How is your writing process? I think everyone's wondering this.
So I used to be a slow writer earlier, but now it takes me about 5 to 6 months in writing a book. So 2.5-3 months go in marinating the idea. You're kind of thinking through the idea again and again, thinking of various perspectives. You're noting down things. You're going to the internet and searching. If it's a place that you're talking about, then you're visiting the place and spending some time there, and so on and so forth. And then it takes me about 2 months to write. Now, usually it's
thriller.
That's it?
So I write now. Yeah, so in 2 months I finish. Because I've worked on it for a long time. I've worked on it for 3 months. In my head, I've written so many notes. And then I get it edited from my end first, from not from me and my friends and stuff like that, but from a professional editor. And then I submit it. And then it's the publisher's call, when do they want to kind of publish it. So that's my, so I take a lot of references from outside, from newspapers, films, songs, and inspirations can even be a line of song, which a lot of authors have told me that it has been there. But the process is essentially not 6 months, the entire process, not more.
So I think I should ask Nan's question now. Where did it go? Yeah. So do you draw, Akash, do you draw from your life or are inspired by writers from the same genre? Do people around you see themselves in your books? Have they ever said what?
That's a question. So first let me tell you that you know that how, and at that time I didn't know Rahul at all. You know when the Aman Bhalla character is introduced? I say that he's Hollywood's George Clooney meets Bollywood's Amanda kind of guy. So at that time, I swear I didn't forget. So having said that, so that could be an inspiration. But having said that, see, initial couple of books can draw a lot from your life. First two books, I think. But after that, it has to be, you have to absorb. There'll be something from your life, that's for sure. Any writer who says that they can write about going to Mars, not being ever on Mars, I don't find it ideal to
work. Yeah.
Yes, you draw inspiration, but then you kind of observe your observation and little things, and then you develop. I keep on reading a lot, like the question was. So I read a book a week.
A book a week, and then you like finish writing a book in 2 months. Who is this person now?
Company on the side.
I am a fan of Stephen King, so all his books I read. Then there are a lot of these new so what I do is I like an author and I then start reading all his books. I write, I love Anna Faire book, I love Robert Dugoni, who's another US great thriller writer, and I really, he's given a blurb on this book. In fact, he was so kind to give a blurb on this. Because I wanted to see, you know, we keep on reading these writers from West. And I really wanted him to read my book. So I reached out to him. I pestered him for a while. And I said, please read my book. And he read my book and he loved it. And he said, I'm ready to give you a comment, etc., etc. And and another author from UK, I like Mark Edwards. I like Lucy Foley. I like AJ Finn. I like, love this writer. Love this book in the year 2020, which I think was the best book. It's called The Silent Patient by Alex Michaelides. And it was his first novel. I like AJ Finn also. So I love reading. When I want to read, I just go on Amazon, search, go do some research about the story, go to Goodreads, read a lot of reviews about the book, and then buy 4, 5, 6 books together. That's how.
Do you read paper books or do you read it on a device?
No, so I read paper books now, but now I've started to like Kindle, because Kindle is something. I was totally a paperback guy like you earlier, but now as I've started to understand Kindle, it's damn good. I find it very convenient. So I'm right like now hooked onto the Kindle quite a lot.
Okay. Yeah.
But I'm still old school. Can't live without the smell of these new books, and you know, it's something.
But you know,
nice.
the straight. Are you a book? Do you keep books or do you give them away?
I'm a book hoarder as well.
Oh, you're a hoarder. No. See, I finish reading a book, I give it away.
Wow.
I don't like keeping it. Yeah.
No, but if it's a book that you love, don't you want to keep it close?
Well, those are very few. Like, I have certain books that are inscribed by an author or that someone has given me, and there's some sort of sentimental value. But those would probably fit on a very small shelf. Everything else I read, I also like sharing. If I like a book and I've finished it, I know I'm not probably going to come back to it. Or if I am, it's going to be many years down the line. I can always get another copy. I'd much rather share it with someone and let them enjoy it.
Not bad.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sunena has a question for you, Rahul. What are your current favorite web shows, and what are your upcoming projects? Do you get time to watch? What stuff have you been watching online?
Oh, I don't. I watch a lot of sitcoms just for fun. I love Frasier. Mm. I watch Fawlty Towers at least once a year from start to finish. I just finished watching this French show called Lupin about a jewel thief, which is great. So yeah, that's what I meant.
Any of the Indian shows, people are going crazy about Scam 1992 and all of that.
I haven't seen that. I just watched The White Tiger, which I really like.
Okay. Yeah.
I haven't read the book, so maybe I'll read the book and see how it's translated from book to screen.
Generally, loyalists always say that a film that is adapted from a book can never match up. You know, this is the general opinion. But Akash, nowadays, because there are, you know, on a lot of content that we are seeing is based on books. Now that you're writing, do you somewhere in the back of your mind have a screenplay for a show? What if this gets picked up? Does that happen?
Well, of course, I have this book, these two books, Duology, can. I don't know about a film, but I think they can be done into two great web series seasons, 8-10 episodes. And so I really think that is done. And, you know, unlike West, where 80-90% of books get made into films or content in films comes from books, here it's now picking up. You know, over the last few years, I think there has been an ecosystem, maybe a small ecosystem that's been created. And people were really working on it to get authors to... authors' creations to be done into films or web shows and stuff like that. So I'm really looking forward that it can be a very engaging and a thrilling content, which is there, which all Netflix and Amazon and all the others today want.
Okay. Tulika has a question, Rahul, for you. Is there a thriller you've read that you'd like to act in?
Oh.
Or that you want should be made into a film?
Yeah, but I don't actually want to say it because I don't want someone else to take it.
Someone else will not take it. You say it and the universe will respond. Don't worry.
I don't know. No, I won't say specific. But just generally, I love crime thrillers. So I would love to do something in that genre for sure. And I like period pieces, things that are set in the past.
Okay.
And they have to be, you know, they have to be slick and stylish and fun and sexy and all that stuff. So.
If these two were made into a web series, I would definitely recommend Rahul for one of the roles, for sure.
But Akash, you're doing everything else, become a producer as well. What's stopping?
I wish I could.
That's not a bad idea, huh?
Stop sleeping. I think that sleeping is just a waste
of time. That's the only, exactly.
Yeah.
Those are the unproductive hours.
Yeah.
You have read the books, Tuti. So I have, when I was thinking of, when I think about Dhruv, okay, and I am not saying this because Rahul is there in the show today, but Rahul did this film called Fireflies, okay, which I've seen. And he plays a very, a great character who is always in a conflict. Okay, and it's a similar conflict. So I have, at the back of my mind, and yes, he's not made an entry into series for a while. So if anyone is listening, please hear my words. Please act on them. Make a series.
Akash, have you ever tried writing a screenplay? Because it's a very different discipline almost. I don't know whether it's something you feel you could do or not.
No, it's very tough, Rav. You're right. I try to be very descriptive when I'm setting up a scene in my books. So, because then the actors do their job more easily. So I would rather set up the scene and then let the actors do their job. I mean, the actors, meaning the characters, do their jobs. But screenplay stuff, I don't think I have the patience to to write. I would rather someone more experienced in that doing it.
Okay. We're running out of time. So guys, if you have any questions, please quickly type those in. Before that, I have a couple of questions. Akash and Rahul, please do weigh in on this as well. A creative outlet, an artist setting his soul free, all that is great, is very idealistic. But at the end of the day, we're also living in a world where you're supposed to make money, where things have to, we define things at hits and flops and, what sells and what doesn't. Do you have these business considerations when you're writing? And now that you are a known name, you're a successful writer, Does that become, does it weigh heavy on your head that I have to include certain elements because, you know, people like this, this sells. I might want to do something different, but I can't risk it now. Does that happen?
So for me, a writer, if he's truly a writer at the core of it, he has to push the envelope, okay, in everything that he writes next. And for that, the publisher needs to hold the hand, which I've been fortunate that my publishers have. But having said that, yes, there are certain things that you need to take care of. See, ultimately, you need to remember that it's everything. So after one has written the book, after the manuscript is done, then it's a business. Okay. Mm. Then it's no more your little creative pursuit that you follow. Then it's a business. Then the book needs to get edited. It needs to get sold. It needs to land in so many outlets. It needs to sell on Amazon, Flipkarts of the world. And it needs to make a viable proposition for the publisher. Okay. Mm. So one will not sell their soul. But I prefer in pushing the envelope further with every creative thing that I do, every book that I write. And obviously, there is a structure, like Rahul had mentioned sometime back, no, that the book needs to be entertaining, you know, at the end of it. You don't want to push that reality into anyone's, everyone's throat. So yes, with entertainment you can take, but I would like to push the envelope. So I am, in that sense, at some point in my life, I want to become like one of those writers who are fearless, you know, who can write whatever they want, and people really like the freedom of that writer, and they read. That's
fun. Rahul, have you ever been in a conflict like this where you just feel that your vision might not be in line with what people expect, how they want you to be, and how have you resolved it?
Oh, I don't think it's that much of an issue for me because I'm not as an actor. I'm often executing someone else's vision for the most part. There are certain choices I make myself, but generally I'm reliant on a director and a writer and a producer. But I feel every creative person should have that conflict. But what's really important is they should also have their own point of view. And if you don't have your own creative point of view, then I feel you should not be in a creative industry because that's the most important thing for an artist is your point of view and how you express that in your work.
Perfect. Yeah. Okay, I have time to take one last question. This is Deepak's. Akash, have you ever had a brush with plays? Have you written a play? Have also figured he's tried everything. Let's ask him about plays as well.
This question is similar. See, play is also, I would assume, very close to a screenplay. It's very very specialized and tough job. I'm happy to do my own little thing in my, and I would like more, but I'm happy to give my input if anyone wants to do it at some point in time. But more than that, I dare not do that.
Right. We are almost at the end of this. Thank you guys for joining in. You've been very generous with your comments, with your questions, and to the gentlemen on screen, Akash and Rahul, thank you. Before I let you go, Akash, finally, the USP of this book, as per you, we have lots of people who are now intrigued. The curiosity quotient is up. Why should they pick this up?
Okay, two things. So it's a perfect thriller duology, as I would say. So pick this up. Both the books are standalone, so you can pick them up. I think the first comment on both the books says it all, and I think that's why you should pick the book. So the first says, and it's a Japanese proverb. It says you have three faces. The first face you show to the world, the second to your friends and family, and the third you don't show it to anyone. Okay, so that's the that's one, and the second one says that which says that vengeance is in my heart, death in my hand, blood and revenge are hammering in my head, which is a William Shakespeare proverb. So pick it up for the perfect thriller, for a story based on great emotional turmoil and relationships, and an end which will leave you overwhelmed. So I think one should pick it up for that.
Super. Okay, we already have a request. This Sana saying, I thought Rahul's going to read a para. And then Harshal says, that will be great. Rahul, would you want to indulge?
Sure. Yes. Which one, though?
Akash, can you...
Yeah, yeah. The first, the Rahul, the first prologue you can read. Prologue you can read.
How long is it? Okay.
No, so, maybe half of it. Maybe.
I only want to know how long my part is. Okay. December 2015, Lal Tiba?
Yeah,
Lal Tiba, Mussoorie. The sky is so pitch black that it's like an impervious, impenetrable blanket. It looks ruthless, this darkness of it, like there is no escaping it, like it is the final frontier. You could try to touch it, poke it, and try to find an opening, but it won't let you go. There are no stars because it has swallowed them all up. Will it swallow me too? Am I going to die? Am I cursed to stare at this shroud of a sky till my last breath? No, I won't let go. I've not learned to let go. My parents, Ma, taught me never give up or to forget, and that means you, A. You did what you should have never done. You knew I had big dreams to chase. You were a part of them. There was no one as good as me. Sid, a fucking gift from God. But then you had to go and mess it all up, bitch. I'd hate it if I were to die. Death doesn't suit me, this insipid state of lifelessness. It seems to cling to me like ill-fitting borrowed clothes, uncomfortable. I want to shrug it off and wear my old comfortable clothes. I want my old life back. But is that even possible now? I lie here like a crumpled piece of shit over this heap of glass shards, all bloodied and wounded. I can't feel any sensations, but my body feels like dead weight. My mind is numb, my face too. Rivulets of blood are seeping out of the punctures in my skin. Blood seems so eager to leave my body and render it lifeless. Bloody fucking renegade. Now I have to wonder whether the smell of my blood will draw the predators on the mountainside. I can't breathe deeply. I'm unable to. My chest won't allow the expansion. Hell, I'm not sure if it's that or I'm incapable of taking a deep breath. No sighs for me. Just an endless wait for death. Once again, it's the sky, just the sky and me. What a destiny. I'm injured, wounded, broken. You pick the word. You, whose face I can still see peering out of the window, a faint shadow of relief in those big eyes. I'm not supposed to die. I'm only 26, damn it. Yet here I am, trapped between life and death in a limbo. All because of you. All because you didn't want me to succeed. All because you had to put yourself before me. You had to, you selfish bitch. I'm too young to die. Only the good die young. That's what they say. But I am not good and not a saint.
That was brilliant. That was spontaneous. Thank you much, Rahul. You were an absolute sport. Thank you for doing
Thank
this.
Thank you. I didn't realize there were all those expletives. I wasn't sure if it was a family show, if I was allowed to say those things.
No, we sprung it on you last minute. Okay. Thank you.
Sunday morning, all this.
But thank you. Thank you, Rahul. Thank you,
Thanks
Akash.
For having
Thank
us,
you.
Thank you. Thank
it was
you
a pleasure. Us. It was a pleasure talking about the book. Guys, if you haven't, do pick up a copy. It is available at the Crosswords bookstore. You can get it online. Thank you so much for joining us. Take care.
Bye.
Thank you.
Thank you.